Hello everyone, HBI Guys Model Workshop here, going to give you a kit review of a kit that I've already built and done a build video on. And I thought, well, that's kind of goofy because I haven't even shown you the whole kit first. So I thought I really need to get to showing you the kit, but I didn't have one at the time. And the kit went together so well and I liked it so much, I went and bought a second copy of it. I picked this up at Michael's local craft store with a half off coupon for under a 10 spot, tax included. Normally they retail for about $12.95, and in the stores they're, you know, kind of silly priced at $17.99, but when you use a half off coupon, then it all works out well. This is for sale locally at Michael's and at Hobby Lobby, and you can always use a 40% off coupon from Hobby Lobby as well. Get it for a nice cheap price. So let's take a look at everything that's in the box. And what I'll do for you guys, if you haven't seen my build of this and the final look at it, I will link all three videos of building this into the description, and you can go ahead and look at those at your leisure. So let's take a look at everything that's in there. First is going to be the instruction manual, and it's kind of thick for a SnapTite model. This is geared towards children. It's a skill level 1, and you know, it's in 1/350th scale, but it does make out for a good size. I don't know if this is actually referenced to any real ship out there. I highly doubt it is. So saying it's 1/350th compared to the real one, I don't know how they figure that out, but that's what they assign to it anyways. You can see the manual, being a skill level 1, this is designed for kids. Foremost, anyone can build one of these, but it is designed for kids. That everything just is huge drawings, great paint guides telling you the few simple paints to use if you wish, and you don't have to paint it if you don't want to. You could buy this for a kid and hand it to them, and I would recommend being there just to cut the parts off the parts trees with a side nipper, but a little bit of older kid, you know, any kid over the age of 6 could also do that themselves. I highly recommend this for a kid. Now, like other, you know, models I've shown you, they've got a blow molded, a polycarbonate or an opaque plastic blow molded sails. This SnapTite kit just has paper sails, and these are it right here. And you just have to cut those out, fold the tabs over, and put it onto the sail, bend it as such if you want it to have sails. You don't have to do it with the sails. There is an option that I'll show you to do it without the sails and still make it look really nice. But you've got some flag options there. You just cut those out, fold them around the masts, use white glue, put them together, and the kid's going to have a flipping blast. Now, I've always told everyone don't be a snob about SnapTite kits, because in the right hands, you can make a SnapTite kit look like a much nicer model. So let's start taking a look at all the stuff that's in the box, and I'll show you why I think it's for everyone. This is going to be the nice stand that it comes with. And on that stand, you can see a cool-looking pirate map, the words Black Diamond, of course, from the nameplate, and a skull. Ooh, scary, scary, scary. So that's a nice little stand that it comes with. That just comes loose in the box. You can use it as it is, or you can paint it up, and you can make this map look really cool on there, too. You can see the nice detail in there. Some of the other parts in the box are the excellent looking hull and deck. It's all one piece. Everything is molded in. The deck is very nicely look. You know, this looks like wood even without being painted, but with the right kind of a stain, paint or wash, that's really going to stand out. And I love that it's a single piece. I don't understand how they can make a kit that they can sell for you know, a tiny amount online with a nice single molded one piece hull with that great wood detail in there and sell it for cheap and make it go together so nice. But when you have a larger model kit, you know, one that's, you know, 18 inches, 24 inches, 36 inches, they mold it in two pieces. It's not like you get any better detail than you did on this. And it's not like when they have a five piece deck that you're going to get any better up close detail than you are on this. And just look at that. That is a sharp looking kit. They got the cannons molded in there, and you can see the actual cannons actually have the dollies cut down, the wheels. You've got some stairs, you've got you know, access points to the cabins, you've got your winches. They've even got front detail on there. You can see all of that looks really nice. All the windows inside, rear deck, that's where your ship's wheels going to mount. Upper windows of the captain's deck, and you can see that's all multi-layered. That's super nice. They should be able to do this on any ship kit. You know, I would leave the cannons and stuff off, and the deck detail, but why they can't mold the deck as one piece, why they can't mold the hull as one piece so that things line up and people don't get frustrated and still have good details beyond me. Two more of the pieces. These are some of the black parts on the parts trees. And these are the side upper hulls. These have your extra cannon that would actually be below decks. You can see the nice detail. They're actually set in their ways. You can see the cutouts for the above deck cannons and the beautiful masthead. Well done on a snap kit. That's why I just keep talking about how impressed I am with where snap kits are nowadays. That's the captain's quarters, all in black plastic, all done well. Even the braces underneath are molded in. The other side is absolutely identical, just the mirror image. And of course, all the cannons have the doors over the top. So, let's get to some more black plastic parts. And there's a lot of parts in here for just being a little kid's snap kit. You got your rat lines, and there's six of them total. Molded very nice. Look at the up-close detail in there. Even the bottom ropes to the blocks and all that are all on there. A little bit of paint work. Those are going to stand out real nice. And then another black tree is going to have your bowsprit, the mast in the front. This is your rudder right there. That'll go off the back of the ship. You have the back of the captain's quarter, the back of the ship. More beautiful molding. You can sand off that lettering if you're going to make it look nicer. You can leave it right where it is. Nobody's really going to notice it. Lifeboat. And the ship's wheel. Right there. Looks real sharp. So it's a very nice kit. We got some more brown parts, and then that is it for the kit. We've got three more trees in the box. And then you're all done with parts. So there's not a huge parts count, and that's because it is a snap-tight kit. It is meant for children. But even though it isn't a high parts count, they've really done good work on the molding. Now, if you don't want to build the ship back here, as you can see, with the sails on it, all you would do is you would use the masts. You're going to use the masts no matter which way you build it. And they've done a beautiful job on those. Of course, these little dots here, you're just going to cut off. But if you want to rig it so that it's actually sitting in port with the sails furled, look at all the detail on that. And some detail painting right on the trees is all you're going to need to do to make those stand out beautifully. And you can see the size of that mast there. You know, that's the big one. And then the beautiful sails that go on it. How nicely those are done. And how the masts themselves are done. You can stain these a darker wood color and then paint your stabilizing ropes. And you can see the final parts tree is exactly the same, just more sails, more furled sails. All up in there, and we'll see how close we can get to see the actual fabric grain on there. Looks very nice. Very well done. And for the price, you can't be beat. Now, my opinion of this kit, what kind of rating would I give this kit on a 1 to 10 scale? 10 out of 10. I would give this thing an 11 out of 10. Maybe 11 and a half. It goes together. If you give this to a kid, and that kid can, you know, do the alphabet, and they can read basic instructions, the kid's going to have this kit together without one single problem. No fit issues. When the parts push together, they stay together. They don't pop apart. They're not like the old Snap-Tight kits that if you tried to put, you know, the upper hull, you know, in here with your side hulls, and when you snap all that together, that 1 minute this is going to come loose and that's going to come loose and you're going to get so mad you're going to snap off the pins. It doesn't do that. The engineers did a wonderful job with this kit, and that's why I can't recommend it enough for kids or adults. And the reason I can recommend it for adults is if you take this kit and start doing some detail painting and you just assemble it, not a drop of glue, mind you, you can end up with a kit that actually looks like that. You can actually make a Snap-Tight kit look like a pricier plastic model ship kit. And that's this exact kit without one part added, without any glue, not a drop. All I did was detail paint everything on the trees and then assemble it. And once it was assembled, I just did a light bit of touch-up painting to cover any gaps that were made when I assembled it. But you can see that when it's put together, there's no unsightly gaps, there's no issues. You can look at the side of the hull there. and there's no giant gaps between the hull and the upper decks, between the rat lines where they snap onto the mast. Nothing. Everything looks good. Even where the masthead comes together fits beautifully. So anybody would have a good time with this kit, whether you gave it to the kid to assemble or if you just threw it together yourself without any paint. For an adult to do it like that, I guess it would be kind of plain. But if you take this nice little Snap-Tite kit, put a few hours into painting it nicely, you can have an absolute beautiful display model that looks realistic, looks like a much more expensive ship kit, but you dropped less than a 10 spot on it. So thanks for watching. I hope you go out and pick up this kit. I can't recommend it enough. Grab it wherever you can. Grab a couple of them. Because if you're like me, after I built the first one, I said, holy crap, I've got to build another one and paint it a little different. Thanks again for watching HPI Guys Model Workshop.